Hello, callers. Welcome back to Viva Barça and welcome to another interesting episode where we are going to discuss on the latest transfer news. We start with Ferran Torres, as the Barça forward will stay at Barça beyond this summer, barring any unexpected twist. We are going to discuss on that as we progress. Secondly, talking about out of favor right back Sergino Dest, as PSV wants Barca to cover 40% of the defender's salary for loan move if it goes through. We are also going to be discussing more on that development. So as we get right into it in much detail, please do ensure to subscribe if you haven't. Turn on the post bell notification to always stay notified whenever I post a new video. Consider liking the video and please watch it right up to the very end. Over the past few months, there have been a lot of speculations regarding the future of Barca forward Ferran Torres. The 23-year-old endured a subpar performance last season and gave the club's need to make big sales. His name was heavily linked with a departure. However, it appears that his situation has taken a complete turnaround, with Sport now reporting that, barring an unexpected twist, Torres will remain a Barcelona player beyond the summer window. This comes on the back of Torres' will and determination to turn things around, with the forward showing up to pre-season training in his best shape physically. The Spanish international has always been insistent that he wishes to stay and succeed at the club, and has shown signs of his recovering his best form over the past month or so. Indeed, Torres was one of Barcelona's best players throughout the preseason, as he scored 3 goals in the club's 4 matches in preparation for the new campaign, even though he did not see any minutes in the season opener against Getafe. Torres has not changed his mind about his future and remains intent on staying put. With Barca potentially looking to bring in another attacker before the window closes, they were said to be planning to offload one of either Torres or Ansu Fati. And as things stand, it appears likely that it will be the academy graduate Fati who takes the fall, rather than the former Manchester City star, who was even handed the number 7 kit following Ousmane Dembele's departure. The fact that Torres could be a viable backup for Robert Lewandowski in the number 9 position stacks the odds in his favour as well. As such, at this point, with the player not looking to leave and the club seeing the positives of his continued stay, an exit looks unlikely. Of course, Ferran Torres has been one of those players that majority of Barca faithfuls have been asking the club to sell him if there is the need to do that. Last season, we saw Ferran being poor in his performances and majority wanting Torres to leave rather than for Ansu Fati to leave. This should come as a shock that Barca are still not even considering selling Ferran Torres as things stand. But earlier this summer, we started seeing rumors of Ferran Torres links and, of course, exit rumors. But the player came more than one occasion to insist that he has a long time to stay at Barca and he wants to improve. He knows very well that last season was not the best and he was poor, and he's determined to change that. He wants to become a better player and impress the Xavi to continue to believe in him and trust him to start him in games. Last week, we did not see him play against Getafe at all. And of course, this week, I think we will likely see him. So let's see how it goes for Ferran. Because talking about the player's future, to even see reports talking about or showing links to other clubs, there aren't reports like that. Instead, Ansu Fati has been the one that uncountable reports have been coming out claiming that he's been linked to clubs outside of Barca, and Xavi himself does not fancy the number 10 again. Despite speculations that he would stay, but Ansu Fati remains very, very sad that his future at Barca is uncertain, as the club does not really count on him. And also, amid links to Atletico Madrid forward Joao Felix, you know, I think if that move was to go through, I think we can just say Ansu Fati might likely, very much likely, depart Barcelona. which will be a disgrace. I think it will not be something good because I've never really wanted Ansu Fati to depart Barca. Despite his subpar performance last season, I think Fati was still better than Ferran Torres. But the way things are showing, it might be the other way around. Maybe we were expecting Ferran not to be a Barca player this summer, but it seems as though Ferran Torres still has a long time to play, as Xavi Hernandez still has plans for the player. Barca have no interest for now to cash in on Ferran, as the player looks like he's going to stay according to his desires. Then on to the final story of discussion. After a relatively rough start to the departures front, Barca have managed to do away with a significant number of players. One name who has been at the exit door for a long time has struggled to find a suitor is Sergio Des. The tables, however, have taken a complete turn in recent weeks. PSV, Eindhoven are in advanced talks with Barca to sign Des, and even Des's agents are said to be convinced of the operation's viability. The Eredivisie side proposed to sign the youngster on a season-long loan with an option to purchase him at the end of the season. It is a similar deal to Des's move to AC Milan last season. There is, however, a twist. While PSV are pushing for the right-back signing, Gerard Romero reports that they demand Barca to cover close to 40 million euros, close to 40% of his salary. The deal is currently being negotiated. While PSV are one of the frontrunners to sign the American star, Ligue 1 side OGC Nice have entered talks with the player too. According to reports last night, the French club are close to signing the player on a similar loan move. However, they too are unwilling to cover Des's entire salary and demand Barca to split the bill. Barcelona's search for suitors for Des was nothing short of a hunt for water in the desert. They have finally struck luck with two European clubs and must close the deal before any late twists arrive. So guys, with that, we have come to an end of this episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Until next time. Bye-bye.